about the better man for your life with House and Home. Yeah, it's all about the better man.
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to the very first episode of House and Home in the year 2017. I'm Izabel Druma, glad you could join me on tonight's show. I'm sure you all have enjoyed your New Year celebration and are geared up for the challenges and possibilities ahead in 2017. New Year's is a time for changes, and these changes can be done to your home and lifestyle. Here on House and Home, we try to help you with tips and ideas. Tonight, we have a brand new lineup for you. We have Easy Meals with Nicole, Shopping with Brian Bell, Kolos Yu Werim, Healthy Minds with our very, very famous Dr. Ambi. On the home habits, we have Theresa. She shows you guys how to make handbags at home. And Godfrey brings to you another brilliant life hack. Now, cooking is an art, and different individuals have their own way of preparing simple meals. Let's direct our attention to the kitchen and join Nicole as she shares with you quick lunch tips on easy meals.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Easy Meals. Tonight I will show you how to do a simple fruit punch. I will show you what to do, and this is something that you can try out so that your kids and friends can enjoy. It's a non-alcoholic drink, just to make that clear. It's up to you if you want to use any creamy soda. I'm using Sprite that I poured in the bowl here, and just some of my favorite fruit. You can put as many different fruits, pineapple and all that sort in. Right now I'll be using 4 slices of watermelon, an apple, lemon and orange. Now I'll just put my bowl of Sprite to this side. Chop up the watermelon. Don't worry about the seeds, you can just throw them in the jug and then have it out. So let's chop them up, throw them in there. Another lot to go. You can also get your kids to help you because it's simple. So here we have all our watermelon going in. Apple, you can either use half of it or you can use the whole. So let me just slice it up. Clean the inside of it so that you don't have the seeds in. The next one. Something simple for you to do. Just make sure your kids don't hold the knives by themselves. You have to be there to monitor them. So let's cut our apple up. Can make them big or small, up to you. I prefer them just like that. Now the good thing about having fruit punch is that you can cut out all your fruits and then fill them up in a jug like the green one here. And what you do, you don't need to eat the fruits. You just add your Sprite or your creamy soda, any soda drink in, and then you just, once it's finished, when the soda is finished, you can keep adding more without changing the fruits. So slice it all up. And then load them in. You have your orange and your lemon. Let's go with the orange first. I'm gonna use half of this orange because this orange is huge. I'll leave the other orange for later. Now you can remove the skin or you can have the skin on. I prefer the orange skin to be there. So I just cut it up. And finally your lemon. So with the lemon, you'd like to cut it in a nice ring. Looks like we're just using half this time. Bit, and then the remaining, I'm just gonna squeeze it in. And then you don't need to throw it away. What you do, you just drop it in there as well. There you go. All right, bring this here. I'll just remove this to the side. vegetables, and then my Sprite. I'll just pour it in here slowly, just make sure it doesn't spill. Put this to the side. Get your spoon and then you mix it up. Mix it up. Now if it's a hot day, you would like to add a bit of ice cubes in it to keep it cool. And just give it a stir again. Push it in. There you have it. So you can use soda or Sprite. So let's bring the spoon out. And remember, as I said earlier on, you don't need to change the fruit, you just keep changing the soda or the Sprite. And for the rest of the fruits, they just remain in the jar. Now let me pour some out. Now I hope you tried this simple recipe. It's a simple fruit juice that you could try. So remember, any fruits that you like. For tonight, I used apple, lemon, orange, and watermelon. And you can use creamy soda or any lemonade juice. I used Sprite for tonight. So there you have it. Easy meals for you.
Now who says Bryanville needs a holiday? Well, Leon is back again to recap on a few things some of us might have missed out in 2016. That's coming up after the break, so stay tuned. Welcome back. Up next, we have Leon at Bryanville with some 2017 shopping ideas to share. Let's find out more.
Belated Happy New Year and welcome to the first segment of Shopping with Bryanville for 2017. I hope your celebrations have been good and you're ready for the year to come. So, in this segment we're going to take a look at what's happened here at Bryanville during the festive season. We'll see what happened and the winners of the Home Centre Christmas Winners Promotion. So, let's not delay, let's get straight into it. Now, I hope Christmas was a good time of the year for you, bringing you joy, laughter and happiness with its festivities. And I know that you've been nice because Santa may have brought you plenty of presents. And how do I know this? Well, I'm glad you asked, because Santa dropped by here to pick up some presents for you. We had lots happening here at Bryanville, as you would imagine, with shoppers. And I know you enjoyed shopping here at Bryanville and making the most of the Christmas catalogs with specials on items and discounted for you during this Christmas time. Now, during the 2016 festive season, we also had our Home Center Christmas Winners Competition running in all our outlets. This simply meant that if you spent 50 kina or more, you would enter the draw. And there were weekly winners and the grand draw prize winners. The weekly winners won a 32-inch Star Vision TV. Now this wasn't just limited to Port Moresby, but there was one winner in each of our 8 outlets around PNG. That means there were 8 winners over the 8-week duration, translating to 64 winners in total. And those winners were... Week 1, Kopi Gulaga, Jeffrey Waira, Vele Vele, Stella Lassie, Willie Aigiri, Salvina Wonu, Alice Taraba, and Peter Lastat. Week 2, Margaret Tepi, Albert Aroa, Harriet Daniel, Andrew Tengil, Samuel Jorogato, Sam Sadik, Hosea Elepas, and Cornelius Botinuk. Week 3, Maddie Wari, Elsie Anthony, John Sipi, Isaac Maraga, Ba Mauro, Matthias Nigur, Milton Taraka, and Graham Mapa. Week 4, Tom Boyama, T. Tassion, Jaja Beraro, Neflin Pisa, Moses Kal, Theresa Abba, Thomas Anis, and Andrew Gawi. Week 5, Gewa Nilini, Thomas Kiligi, Jacinta Malaysa, Gloria Samiak, Barclay Kaupa, Celian Kass, Lawrence Kinakap, and Clarence Boma. Week 6, Ranu Badra, Ethel Pamumu, Margaret Vasso, Nicole Monmai, Moho Hatenave, Jason Kakai, Michael Kavanamur, and Malaya Leslie. Week 7, Jonathan Ezekiel, Namsen Lovai, Samson Kua, Ray Key, Moiva Konisimo, Benjamin Manareng, Ashley Tiran, and Barry Kunum. Week 8, Romela Cespedes, Winnie Benudi, Sharon Nalu, Carol Telang, Kimo, Kelly Salang, Daniel Bai and Umar Nuka. Congratulations to the weekly winners. I know you'll enjoy watching all your favorite shows on your new TV. The next lot of winners were the grand draw prize winners. This included a 5,000 kina gift voucher and two 1,000 kina gift vouchers to be spent at any Brian Bell, not just limited in Port Moresby, but to the other centres around PNG. That's from Mount Hagen, Goroka, Leh, Medang and Kokopo, Vision City, Plaza and our Gordon's Home Centre. This was drawn on the Wednesday the 28th at 10 a.m. at the respective home centre outlets. There were three winners each from each of the locations, translating to 24 winners. These winners are... From Brian Bell Medang, the 5,000 kina winner is Galaxy Terana, and the 1,000 kina winners are Robert Malana and Abraham Gene. Brian Bell Kokopo, the 5,000 kina winner is Cecilia Rubinette. The 1,000 kina gift voucher winners are Ali Maliai and Ravu Furigi. Brian Bell Hagen, the 5,000 kina winner is Jenny Paul, and the 1,000 kina winners are Nancy Berry and Joseph Willie. From Brian Bell Goroka, the 5,000 kina gift voucher winner is Elizabeth B. Joseph. The 1,000 kina gift voucher winners are Josephine Set and Yvonne Minimba. From Brian Bell Leh, the 5,000 kina gift voucher winner is Alani Isaac. And the 1,000 kina gift voucher winners are Josephine Nguba and Javina Jockey. Brian Bell Gordon's Home Center. The 5,000 gift voucher winner is Raka Rose Manoka. The 1,000 kina gift vouchers go to Donna Nagul and Peter Tombala. Brian Bell VC, the 5,000 kina gift voucher winner is Ronald Malona. And the 1,000 kina gift voucher winners are Ray William and Richard Namaliu. Brian Bell Plaza, 5,000 kina gift voucher goes to Avia Meki, and 1,000 kina gift vouchers go to Ujima Kalout and Sam Gelly. A massive congratulations to all the winners of those vouchers. I know you've ended off 2016 in the right way, and you're starting 2017 on the right foot. Also with the new year comes new dreams, hopes, aspirations and goals. And Brian Bell is always looking to improve to better serve you, our customers. However, at the same time, we understand that we provide great service, products, and value to you, our customers. That has made us a reputable company in PNG. Great value, understanding the importance of family and one talks in PNG and modeling our business around that. Professional service, a strong staff base giving you, our customers, advice and listening to help and find the best product for you. Quality products like Sharp, Breville, Fisher & Paykel and West Point, we have the best products available. These are all backed by our quality spare parts and service division. And if there's any issues with the products you buy from us, you can simply bring it back to us for repair. Well, there you have it, folks. Thank you for your time and congratulations to all the winners of the Home Center Christmas Winners Promotion. I know you'll enjoy all your prizes. Also, I'd like to bid you all the best in 2017. And always remember, great service, quality products, and great value. That's Brian Bell. Until our next time together, it's goodbye and God bless.
So that was pretty much what happened during the festive season in 2016. And yes, congratulations to the Home Center Christmas competition winners. There we go again with Brian Bell, great shopping ideas. Thank you, Leon. Viewers, we'll head out for a break and be back with more. Hello everyone and welcome to this segment of Kolos Yu Werim. My name is Izabel Juma and I'll be showing you some great clothing ideas you can try out this Christmas. So let's check it out.
We have seen throughout the year PNG clothing expanding with creativity. We have seen PNG clothing around the world and we've even seen it hitting celebrities. Which is why I'll be taking you back to one of PNG's beautiful classics, the meri blouse. Of course, we will not be forgetting about the male audience out there. We have something special just for you.
The meri blouse has become one of PNG's iconic clothing. You may have or have not noticed that there are many new meri blouses hitting PNG with an amazing flair. Incorporating new designs, taking new looks, some peeking out to different parts of the world, to Persian, to Hindi, to Oriental and more. Going diverse with its printing that really captures everything. And it's amazing how it not only captures local design, but a whole new global taste to it. These are a few of the many brilliant designs. They are great for all women of all ages, and if you're looking for something special or something new to start off your new year, This is a terrific start. It's comfortable, stylish, and climate appropriate.
Down here at the Naked Fish, I'll be showing you something special from Focus Graphic Design Studio.
Inspired by the NGI province, Focus Graphic Design Studios have taken provincial designing to a whole new level. If you're looking for something to start your new year off, something special, something to spice up your wardrobe, then these are some fantastic ideas you can try out. Now I have a special guest with me, and his name is Constantine Baez. He's one of the most amazing yet creative designers around PNG, and we'll be discussing some of his incredible designs here on Kolos Yu Werim.
I'm from Noelin province. Basically it started from first ever design I came up with was for the PNG softball training squad singlets. Then it carried on from there, designing for the companies and other sporting clubs. So my partner, who is from Eastern Britain, decided to told me to come up with a design for Eastern Britain Day. So that's where it started. I didn't start off with clothing. I started off designing other stuff as well, like business cards, and so it, like, step by step grew up from and gradually ended up designing clothing. Yeah. Thinking of starting my own label, clothing label, but that's, you know, in the pipeline. It's we're slowly at the infant stage at the moment, so slowly growing as we go along, we'll, you know, expand. East New Britain was the benchmark, and then Nips, we gradually went to design Nips, and then now Manus is coming along, and then followed by Buka, Arab, and then we'll slowly go out to other provinces. So by next year, you'll see a lot of designs for the other provinces coming out. Okay, with all my designs, I try to be unique in a certain sense. I have my own style in design. So I try to capture what signifies that province. So with EMV, you'll see all the tuk-tuk and the shell money, the propeller, pomio, and the binding dances. They all signify East New Britain, and they incorporate their colors for the color of the flag is within the shirt itself as well. So the same with Nips, we've added the Miss, which is the shell money, the Malangan mask, which is an iconic figure when doing feasts and mass festivals and stuff like that. And yeah, the Southern Cross star, which features on every flag of there, and also the colors as well. And I also like to thank my clients and customers for trusting in Focus Graphic Designs. If anyone is interested in our provincial designs, they can find us on Facebook page, our Facebook page called Focus Graphic Design Studio. Yeah, they can see our contact details around there, so they can get in touch with us there.
Those were just a mere handful of the many amazing Kolos around PNG. My name is Izabel Druma. Join me again next time on Kolos Yu Werim. Bye for now. Well, those are some fantastic collections right there. Ladies will definitely relate. When we come back after the break, we have Healthy Minds with Dr. Ambi, joined by Theresa for an important topic discussion to guide us in the brand new year. Talk about Haus and Home.
This is Healthy Mind with Dr. Ambi, proudly brought to you by Telecom PNG Limited.
A blessed new year to you all, viewers out there who are watching right now. Thank you for joining us on Healthy Minds with Dr. Ambi. I am here with Dr. Ambi and we'll be sharing with you about how to stay happy. Well, 2016, we have been talking about issues, mental issues like post-traumatic stress disorder and anxiety, depression, all those. But for 2017, we've decided to bring something fresh and Dr. Ambi will help us on how to stay happy.
Well, thank you, Theresa, because it's wonderful to be with you again.
Yes.
And Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you. I hope you've enjoyed your holidays.
Oh, I did a bit. You know, obviously, we are going to talk about stay happiness.
Yes.
So, well, we have to stay happy, isn't it? So, unless we stay happy, I'm sure the viewers will be very excited about it. Well, viewers, like Theresa said, happiness is the meaning and the purpose of life itself. Now, many times you meet by looking more same, tripla heavy come up, now you meet talk, all kind of problems, that's all, now you meet stop, yeah. So people, many people think happiness is one of the most sort of thing that you want to set as a goal to achieve throughout your lifetime,
true,
isn't
yes
it? So, and sometimes when you say talk about happiness, people think, oh, having a car or a big time house is a happiness. Do you think that's a happiness? No way.
It's like a part-time happiness.
Of course. It's like, I mean, you need a car, you need a house. Yes, we do
exactly
need that. But happiness is one thing you may forget or say. Happiness is available to all of us. And it is important for us to think how we can stay happiness. Yes.
Yeah.
Now, Theresa, I think in the last time when we talk about, you also told me, come on, doctor, tell us how can
yes
we be happy. Is that right? So you still want me to talk about the
please,
different...
Please, Dr. Ambi. I know our friends are really looking forward to what you have prepared
yes
to share with us. So
I try to put, I try to put few points together. So, well, viewers, let me tell you. Number one is to the few ways that you can start being happy, because when you're happy, you are sick free and you are the most beautiful person on earth. So first thing is to do what you love. That is one of the important things for us to know. Because if you love cooking or if you love writing or playing, you know, you must also do what you love apart from the career. But if you think that somebody is forced to do something, obviously you know how much unhappiness you have it within yourself. So do what you love is one of them. Okay. Help others. Okay, number two. That means like when you achieve so much in your lifetime as a goal and you have achieved and you're happy, and we must also think how we can help others. That doesn't mean that you're going to go beyond means to now work in something that you can't afford to do that. But I think there are many ways you can help others and you can get that happiness in yourself. So number two is help others. Number three is be thankful. Many times you may look in Muslim law, you walk about law even in our city, yeah? You look in, good blood changes happen, all hamamas is up, you may go kaikai olgata hap, you know, look at the way the infrastructure change and all these kind of things. But we're not thankful to what they have done for us, what the government has done for us, what the family has done for us. So it is important for us to be thankful and grateful. Sometime, even if you look at in your lifetime, you by looking or saying you come through the hard time, people, different people have helped you. But sometimes it's important for you to sit down and be grateful to what you have gone through, be grateful and thankful to what you have achieved so far before even you start having more yet life blow you and me. Yeah? So number five, share with others. Share with others means like, you know, you got some kind, something God and blessing you pinis, now plenty something him stop lo you, now give him lick something lo blessing lo narapla man. And when you share with others, then you, like for me, I love sharing my knowledge, I love sharing, you know, what I can and what can I afford, or no good me put him all get a thing lo me, na save lo me, me yet kiss him. Now, good. So it's suppose you share. So you can share knowledge, you can share your blessing, you can share many things you can share. And when you share, I get very happy. So that's my personal view. So that's one of the way of sharing with others is very important. Number five is smile more. Smile more is because smile, you know, we can go through hard time. I've gone through hard time, I'm sure, Theresa, you have gone through. But I'm important through law. Smile and be plus something. Do you agree with me? I mean, many times you said, "Oh, doctor, I know you're tired, but you keep smiling." So, well, viewers, smile at all time, okay? Number six is to exercise. Every time you need to, actually every week, at least thrice a week, walk in some like a brisk walk, or because that produces endorphin in your mind, and that makes you to feel good about yourself and be happy and be energetic. So exercise is one of the natural way of stirring or creating an endorphin in your mind, I mean in your brain. Number seven, seek out help. Now plenty time people are not very happy or they were not, the personalities are different. So some people might not less to ask him all help. Some people, you know, same come me like in bus fare or come gammon long old. No, I'm not talking about when you have really issues, you reach out and ask for help. Emi tripla em hama masib by kama. Number eight, find ways to manage stress. Well, we will over the period of this year, we will talk about managing stress, I'm sure, at one point of time. But you must also give him some kind of strategies. What are the external factors which is creating trouble to you? And what are the internal factors a problem creating? And some way you can rouse in this problem, how you can overcome this. So you need to work on how to manage stress, the bad stress, not good stress. Well, eat healthy, all right? Eat healthy is, I mean, like eat good fruits and nutritional values, things you might have to do. And spend time with your loved ones, that's number 10. Spend time with your loved ones, because most of the time, in the midst of your work and issues, you forget thinking about everyone and your loved ones, your wives or children or something. The more you spend time with your loved one, there is an inner happiness which comes in you, talk about it. Number 11, get rid of all the negative thinking. You know, most of the time we get tormented by negative. Start thinking positive. Give more gifts, what you can do, and also forgive and forget, okay? Because people do a lot of bad things to you, and even the backstabbers are there. You talk about, say, maybe one black and Judah, or kind description you may can do, or can get up and betray you, or this like kind. Maybe good black passing, or same time, Papa God, and resurrect penis now. Maybe stop one time, you may, maybe life stop, so that power of forgiveness is huge. Okay, so forgive and forget. Once you do that, it is good for your own health, and God takes control what he needs to do to those people, you see. So forgive and forget is one of the powerful way to do things. And number 12, or the 14, take a walk in the nature. That means you can walk around in a natural way of going to bush, or like, you know, going to the park and things like that, which create some kind of beautiful feelings in your mind. And number 15 is be yourself. Be yourself is, we always want to imitate another person. We got our own personality. We got the goodness. God has already put that happiness within yourself. If you are yourself and you know how to deal with all mitok-tok calls, now you hamamas man, you hamamas meri. Because this la hamamas is important, lo. Stay healthy, no? That's a very important way of achieving goal with being happiness, Theresa. Yeah. Yes.
All right, Doctor, we've covered quite a good number of points, and what I really, really loved was do what you love, you know. There was this is something, you know, most people don't recognize, they don't work towards it, they don't work, spend time to build at what they love, you know. Most of the time they just do things that are opposite to what they should do. But then if you keep doing what you love, maintaining it, nurture it, it will take you places. It will give you something good. What you do, spend time to build it, it will do something good to you. So doctor, thank you so much for, you know, helping us and pointing out those wonderful ideas on how we can stay healthy, because 2017, I believe, is going to be a very challenging year for those who are watching, every one of us. So
it's
so
a simple step. Yes. It's a simple thing. Yeah. I was doing. It's nothing complicated.
Yes.
When you're by yourself and be yourself, so, and stay in the line with Papa God. Now, when I'm something, I'm teaching lo you me. Now, then all get a something by come good through. Yeah.
And one of the things people don't, you know, forgive and forget. This is one of the only thing that people need to really practice. You know, the more you keep going back, the more you think about your past, it will keep you stagnant. You know, you'll stagger all your life. But the most important thing is to forgive and forget. That will take you to the next level. You know.
Exactly.
Thank you so much, Dr. Abby.
And I love forgive and forget.
That's right.
No, that's where I saw the power of God. Yes.
Thank you so much, Dr. Abby. Well, viewers, what can we say? That's what Dr. Abby says every time when she does Healthy Minds. What can we say? This is the brand new year 2017. Let's all be positive, absorb what is good, and let go what is bad. And that will take you to the next level. And from step by step, little by little, you will reach that goal you've been striving to reach. So the only encouragement we can give to you, or I can give to you, is that smile, be yourself, like what Dr. Abby said. Most people spend most of their time trying to be someone else. But if you try to be yourself, people will see you as you. So please don't forget to join us next time for another wonderful episode of Healthy Minds with Dr. Abby. So until the next time, don't forget to keep an eye out for another wonderful edition of Healthy Minds with Dr. Abby. Good night.
Healthy Mind was proudly brought to you by Telecom PNG Limited.
Thank you, Dr. Ambi, and I hope we have taken notes of what she has shared. We'll take a break for now, but coming up, we have Home Habits with Theresa.
It's all about house and home.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Home Habits. I'm so glad you could join me. Tonight I will be showing you how to make a side bag. This is specially for men. I've been doing a lot of stuff for women, and I've decided to show you a simple project, which is the men's side bag. So for this project, you will need, of course, your pins, your tape measure, your scissors, and your sewing machine, of course. So let's start off with the measurements. For the handles, well, for the handle, I have a plain color. I chose plain to be the outside part of the bag because, well, most men choose to be plain and a little bit of flavor to the plain color. So I chose the plain color to be the handle, which is 8 by 31 inches. And I have my pocket as well to be on the plain color. My floral fabric. This is so beautiful. It's supposed to be outside, but then, like I said, most men choose to be plain. So this is the lining, the inside part of the bag, and the plain color, which is the main part of the bag. So both the lining and the plain color have the same measurements. So they will actually measure, let me use my tape measure here. So both are 12 by 13 inches, 14. So both are 12 by 14 inches. So let's begin. I am going to start with the handle of the bag. Okay, so for the handle, I've decided to use a different stitch. This is one of my favorite stitches. It's a decorative stitch. So I normally use this on plain fabrics. So this is what I'm gonna do on the machine. I'm gonna turn this so that the pointer is in between 3 and 2. Same on this side. And I'll have to change the stitch here. So you can see that the stitch is showing out clearly on the plain fabric. So as you can see, my plain fabric is now decorated with a nice looking stitch. So my handle is done. I'm gonna work on my lining and the main part of the bag. So the next thing I'm doing, I am going to sew my pocket onto the outside part of the bag. Now you will notice that I've ironed each side. This is so that it makes it easier for you to mark correctly and pin so that you don't have a hard time sewing all the way around. You can see that I've already pinned my pocket onto the outside part of the bag. This is the one I am sewing. If you're sewing your pocket, always start on this side and come all the way around. I am using a straight stitch because this is a floral fabric. So I don't think it's a great idea to use a decorative stitch onto a floral fabric because it's not really gonna show up. So there you have it. That's how it's gonna look like on the plain fabric. So make sure that the lining is facing the other lining and the plain fabric. This is the outside part of the bag, outside part of the bag. So make sure that the lining is facing the other lining, and same applies to the plain fabric. I will start sewing here and all the way around. And I'm gonna leave an opening here so that I can flip the bag right side out. So you can see that I left an opening here so that I can flip the bag right side out. So I'm gonna start flipping it now. Okay. The next thing I'm doing is to run a straight stitch to close the opening right here. So all you do is fold in and start sewing. The lining is the inside part of the bag, so it's still okay. The stitch is hidden. What I'll do is push the lining in. I am going to run a decorative stitch again all the way around, but this time I am applying the handle. It's always important to use your pins because it makes it easier for you to sew and the measurements are accurate. So I'm going to be using a decorative stitch to sew all the way around. So the last thing I'm doing is to hem this. So there you go. This is the side bag for men. I've always wanted to show you all, and finally I did. This is the side bag for men, and I'm sure you will try one for yourself at home. Until the next time, don't forget to join me on another DIY project right here on Home Habits. Goodbye.
Thank you, Theresa. And she actually gave the bag to her brother, and he was like, hey, thanks. I was thinking of buying a bag just like this one for myself, and you did one for me. Aw, Theresa, that was a lovely gesture. We'll head on out for a short break, but when we get back, we've got Life Hacks with Godfrey Men. We'll see you after these short messages.
Everybody drinks soft drinks. Well, not everybody, but no matter where you go, you're bound to find these aluminum cans, empty or full. But if you don't dispose of them properly, it can do a lot of harm to the environment. That's why for this episode of Life Hacks, I'm gonna show you guys some awesome soft drink hacks that you probably didn't know about. So, let's get started.
Incredibly awesome hack number one, using the can as an apple peeler. Now, this is gonna be a little tricky, so be careful with this particular hack. So, to begin, use your scissors to separate the top part of the can from the rest of the can. All you're gonna need is just this top bit. Now before we continue, this bit's edges are really sharp, so it can be quite dangerous. To fix that, you take your pliers and you fold these edges in to make them less life-threatening. And there you go, we're almost done with our peeler. Now that it's a lot less dangerous, remove the tab from the top of the can. The next step is to curve this piece so that it'll make it easier when you peel. You can use the pliers here to speed things up. And there you have it, your very own apple peeler. All you have to do is hold it right here. Place the open side where the tab used to be against the apple. And this will do all the peeling, while all you have to do is pull down. Awesome hack number two. And here's a cool hack that you probably didn't know about. Sick of your straw floating out of your can drink? Well, just take the tab, twist it around, and slide your straw through it. Simple! Less floaty straws. Now this next hack is pretty cool, and also serves as more of a decoration. You can use the aluminum cylinder as a coaster to place other drinks on. Firstly, you'll have to cut off the top and the bottom. Once you're left with just the cylinder, cut it in half, and then fold it into a smaller rectangle. Cut it again so that the shape becomes squarer. This will be our coaster. But then again, you can cut it into any shape you want, as long as you're able to place drinks and whatnot onto it. And it's almost done! Our final step is to cover the edges with tape to make it safer to handle. And there you have it. Your coaster is done and ready to protect your hardwood surfaces from those drinks. Now, speaking of surfaces to place things on, the next thing you're going to make is a candle holder. This one is super easy. All you need is the very lower base of the can. Separate it from the rest of the can. And there you have it. You've got an excellent fireproof base for a candle.
And there you have it. I hope you all found those life hacks to be pretty useful. They're definitely a better alternative to disposing these cans in the wrong way.
Something about life hacks is that you create the best out of waste. Well, viewers, that's all we have for you on this episode. Please keep an eye out for more household tips and stories in the upcoming episode. For any comments on any of the features, contact the House and Home team on the email address now showing on your screen. You can also get in touch with us through our House and Home Facebook page. And if you want to view this episode again, visit MTV online. I'm Izabel Druma, and on behalf of the House and Home team, pleasant viewing, stay safe, and enjoy the rest of your week. Goodbye.
It's all about the better man for your life with House and Home.